Hey guys, this is Amin. If you are struggling to create a professional looking web design in Figma, this video is for you. By the end of this video, you will have learned about how to work with Figma's UI3, auto layout, constraint, and many other things. Let's dive in. Here is my design file, and you can also download it from the link in the description. Let's go through the tool and see what we have here. Layers panel. Found on the left, it displays the structure of all design elements and the hierarchy of them. Toolbar. At the center button, you will find tools like Move Tools, Region Tools, Shape Tools, Creation Tools, Text Tools, Comment Tools, and Action Tools. And in the right, we have Properties panel. This panel offers settings or properties for the selected tools or elements. Alright, let's go to work. Creating a frame from here or pressing F. A 100 to 100 frame will appear. Rename it to Desktop. Then adjust the dimension in Properties panel, width 1440, height 900. After that, set the layout grid by click on the frame, and in the Properties panel, you can find Add Layout Grid. Change it to Columns, set the columns count 12, margin 80, and gutter 20. To hide the grid during design, press Ctrl G on Mac and Ctrl Shift 4 on Windows. I also reduced the opacity of my grids to 2%. I already created the background for my design and drag and drop it into my frame. Set the constraint to left and right and top to keep my background responsive. Then select the background element from the layer panel, then lock the entire element to not interfere with my other components on top. And as you can see, if I resize my frame, my background stays center. Then I'm going to create my navigation. First item is my logo. Add a text element for the logo, Amin Design. Font Roboto, bold, size 24, color black. Align it to the top far left and set the constraint to top left. And the next one is navigation links. Add a text, Font Roboto, medium, size 16, color black, and type about. Duplicate the text by holding Alt and dragging, and change the text to Program, and again to Price, and then I add another as Content. By holding Shift, select them all, use Auto Layout by Shift and A to space them 32 pixels apart. And set the constraint to left and right and top. By that, my navigation always stays in the center, no matter if I change the frame width. And also, I want to have the button group on top right. Outside of my frame, add text sign in, Font Roboto, regular, size 16, color white. Frame by Shift A, padding 12 and 12, alignment center, background color black, rounded corner 8 pixels. Now I created one button. And I copy it by Command D on Mac and Control D on Windows. Select the text and change the color to black. Set the background color to gray, for instance F5, and add 1 pixel stroke to the button. Select both buttons. Use Auto Layout by pressing Shift A on keyboard to space them 8 pixels apart. Align it to the top right and set the constraint to top and right. Once again, with setting the constraint, if I resize the frame, my elements stay as they are. You can also check my video in detail about the constraint and auto layout in Figma in the link in the description. Next step is adding the title and description. Create a title, crafting experience that click. Font Roboto, bold, size 56, uppercase. Center the text and set the width to fill container. Then add your description, Font Roboto, regular, size 32, color black, and also set the width to fill container. I believe that design is about more than just aesthetics. It's about crafting meaningful experience that engage users and make the lasting impact. Then align it with previous text and select the header and description and use auto layout by Shift and A to space them 24 pixels apart. Then set the constraint to a scale.
Then I want to have a get in touch call to action after my description, and simply by holding option on my keyboard, I drag the call to action from the top and place it under my description and change the text to get in touch. And the next element in my design is my photo. I paste my photo in my Figma file, then turn off my grid with Ctrl G to see what I'm doing and adjust the size. To make it look nicer, I add corner radius for 12 and add the stroke for 3 pixels. Then under effect, I add drop shadow to it, position it X and Y 4, blur 34, and spread it for 7. Well done, you've successfully designed a professional landing page in Figma. If you found this video helpful, give the video a thumbs up and explore more videos in my channel.